Any sisters have any questions?
I've been living alone in Bombay. I'm working here. I'm working for a media organization, and I'm being told that it's wrong for me to live alone. And another thing would be, which confuses me, because the Prophet also said that, you know, I'm not really sure, but if you have to go for education, you can go to China, you know, like, and that's for both men and women. So I'm working here and I'm living alone and I'm very ambitious. I want to work, and I've been told that I can't. So what exactly is it that the Quran says for me?
Sister has a question that she has come to Bombay. She lives in Bombay. She's working in Mumbai and she lives alone. So people have said that living alone is prohibited. She gave the reference that the Prophet said you can even go to China to get education. So why can't I come here? So what am I doing? Is it right or wrong? So the point number one, that the hadith you quoted, that you can even go to China for knowledge, is a zaif hadith. In fact, it's a maudu hadith. It's a fabricated hadith. Because at the time of the Prophet, China was in the center of education. But there are many other verses and hadith of the Prophet. For example, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, mentioned in Baihaqi and Ibn Majah, it is obligatory on every Muslim, man or woman, to acquire knowledge. The first guidance given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran was Iqra. Surah Iqra, chapter 96, verse number 1, is to read, to recite. So education is important, but the hadith you quoted was Zaif and Maudu. Point number 2, you said that, is it fine that you're living alone and you're working? As far as living alone for a woman, a woman should always live with a mahram when she travels outside or overnight. Since I understand you have come from outside Bombay and are living in Bombay. So when you're traveling outside and when you're living overnight, you should be with a mahram. Either with your husband if you're married, or with your father, or with your brother, mahram, or maybe a group of ladies staying together. Because Islam believes in protection of the woman. It is not that Islam restricts the freedom. People tell me that no, Islam restricts the freedom of the woman, that she has to go with mahram. And I want to give the example that whenever the president of America, when he travels, he has many bodyguards. Bodyguards, security, why? He has a special plane, why? Not that we want to degrade the president of a country, we want to protect. Like when George Bush also came, he came in his own aeroplane, Air Force One. It is better than a bungalow and what all, it came as headlines in the newspapers, what facilities the Air Force One has. So many facilities if anything goes wrong. Why? Not that they want to restrict the freedom of the president of America, they want to take care. Similarly, in Islam, we want to take care of a woman. That is the reason we want to see that she is secured. Point number one. So for a woman to go outside and stay alone, even for education, is wrong. She can have other alternatives. She can stay with a relative, or she can stay with a group of women. Not that she can stay alone even for education. Fine, or she stays in ladies' hostel. There are many ulmas. Sheikhs have given fatwa, and as a last resort, best is with the mahram. As a last resort, if she travels and stays in a girl's hostel and seeing the security and everything, X, Y, Z, many conditions are there, then it may be permitted, which is some of the sheikhs object. And for working, sister, point number one, a woman need not work in Islam. In Islam, a woman doesn't have to earn for her living. It is the duty of the man in the family. Before she is married, it is the duty of the father and the brother. And after she's married, it is the duty of the husband and the son to look after lodging, boarding, clothing, and all financial aspects. In Islam, a woman need not work. But if she wishes to work, and she wants to contribute, she can work as long as the work is within the purview of the Islamic Sharia. But naturally, she can't do any work which is against the Sharia, which breaks the hijab. For example, modeling, singing, etc. And many works which is prohibited for the woman are also prohibited for the man. Like working in a gambling den, working in a alcoholic bar, doing dishonest business. So whatever work she's doing, it should be within the purview of Islamic Sharia. If she's working in an organization, there should be proper segregation of sexes. She can't work as the typist or secretary of a boss, and then they're in the same room, and she's typing a letter. Our Prophet said, if a man and a woman, na mahram, are in the same room alone, then the third person is the devil. So if all the rules of the Sharia are followed, and the hijab is not broken, and if she works an organization, it's allowed. But if she breaks the Islamic Sharia, she doesn't have to work, it's haram. Point number one. Point number two, even if we're working, going to another city and staying alone in a house, renting a house, according to me, it's haram. According to Islam, it's haram. Because it's the duty of her father or brother, if she's not married, to look after lodging, boarding, clothing, and financial aspect. If she's married, it's the duty of the husband and the son to look after her. If not, then it is the duty of the ummah. So she need not work. No one can force her to work. Even if they are poor, the husband cannot force her. Husband can request, and if she wishes to work as long as the work she is doing within the Islamic Sharia, that is permitted. So, you sister, hope you have got the answer.